Hello everybody, welcome back to my stream. I haven't streamed in a week, and as somebody who's trying to become Twitch affiliate, that's basically a surefire guaranteed way to, not get affiliate, because you need to stream, for a week and for a certain amount of hours and maintain a viewership of 3 people, per stream on average a month. So yeah, not streaming for a week, definitely counterintuitive to earning affiliate. But I'm back now, and I'm continuing my playthrough of Bloodstained, Curse of the Moon. I'm gonna finish Nightmare Mode today, hopefully, that's the plan. I'm already halfway through it, so... Yeah, like, I can't think of any reason why I wouldn't be able to finish it today, unless it actually turned out to be way harder than I expect. So yeah, again, I apologize for not streaming for so long, and hopefully the audio levels and everything is okay. Hopefully you can hear me and the game alright. Relearn the game a bit before I play again, but hopefully it's... I shouldn't have too much trouble. Yeah, we're fine. Oh, come on. Okay, that was no problem. I got worried about nothing. I'm not even hurt yet. This could be a problem. And my... Oh, okay, never mind. We're good. Man, the hitbox of Miriam's whip is pretty big. Nice. Come on. You know what? I'll go this way. It will be as long as... Okay. I should be good. Yeah, that was definitely worth it. I didn't mean to slide. Since I'm gonna need her for the boss the most. Thank you. That seems so much easier when I had some get to. Speaking of which, I'll bet you he's gonna be the final boss of Nightmare Mode, given how the game ends when you recruit everybody. Or maybe that's just how it ends in all endings. I don't know. I got a heart just to lose it again. Oh, this is not looking good. I just barely managed to salvage that. No. Oh, I think I got an extra life from that. Nice. And that appears to be a health upgrade. Nice! And it refills my health. Alright, my weapon energy is all full. That's right. We're in windy circumstances now. I have to wonder if it's even worth it to come into this room. There doesn't seem to be anything here. And the enemies don't respawn. Nice. I kind of didn't want to do that, but, you know, I wasn't about to get hit again. Probably not a good idea to try to fight him with Jeeble. Imagine trying to fight a boss with Alfred. like this. Things are not looking good for me. I should try doing that actually. Sliding underneath the completely forgot how that fight ends. But we survived. That's all that matters. Actually never saw Alfred's victory pose before, so that's interesting. I managed to get through that boss in one try, which is very good. Oh. I didn't realize that enemy shield bounced you back unless that was added in nightmare mode. Nope. Okay, good. Oh god. Yeah, I'm not taking a chance. I shouldn't have picked that up. Oh wait, actually. Nice. I almost didn't manage to collect that. Excuse me. So I assume that gauntlet is a, excuse me. Strength power up, since enemies seem to die faster now. Everybody's at full health, good. This might not be as hard as I think. Well, I shouldn't speak too soon. It still might be as hard as I imagine it could be. We'll see if that was a good pickup or not. I'm not risking jumping over that, even though it looks pretty safe. Almost killed myself there. Oh, that's really bad. At least I got some health back. Okay. Okay, this is clearly not the intended way. This is clearly the end of an alternate path rather than... Alright. I should realize by now that straightforward is the way forward, and no, I forgot about these guys. And if I remember correctly, that sand is actually instant death. I was right. No juggle. That hurts. And I can't pick up that one up now. Actually, let me see. It might actually be better to have. Well, I can't get the one up, so I said. Suppose there's no point in taking that path. Yeah, my weapons definitely deal more damage now. Really worried he was still gonna be able to hit me, even though. This level. On the bright side, I got a 1-up, so... When I die here, I've minimized the damage, so to speak. That shield, though... and this is probably where I die. Now, of course, the shield had to go away just as he was about to hit me. I forgot that. The room leading up to this boss is this room. On the bright side, I did make it this far, which means that when I do die, it's gonna be as close to the boss as I can be, like when I lose a life. I'll honestly be shocked if I manage to beat this boss with Alfred. There's no way I was gonna be able to do this. Ugh. He's just floating in midair there. Oof. On the bright side, at least I've got this weapon. I might just... Yeah. Oh! The shield carries over when you switch characters! Oh! This changes things completely. Oh my god. Come on, I use the sub-weapon! Well, it doesn't matter since, like I said, Alfred's not exactly meant for killing bosses. Whoa. I just did a really awkward backwards jump. What the hell was that? I have less weapon energy now, but there's no way I was gonna go through that. Which, let me just fly over everything, because I'd rather have more health than less for this fight. Damn it. Yeah, this boss is gonna cause me problems, for sure. This is a dead fight. I am so screwed here. I could actually lose all of my lives here. Weapon now. All right. Damn it. And I immediately forgot that I have a worst weapon. I'm just gonna let myself get hit. Ah. Do I really need to go that way, though? Of course I have to get hit after picking up the... I'll try to get as far as I can with Jeebo here, but it's not looking good since I'm already at half health. Switched. I could have won that. Still got plenty of weapon energy. That shield seems to be more useful than the weapon I have on Miriam right now, so I think I'll just stick to using that. No! Oh, I completely screwed that up. The shield protects me from the blood rain, thank God. Oh, I always forget about that. At least it didn't kill me. Okay. We got everybody back and an extra life. And the boss of the next level is actually easier than the last two, so... As long as we make it to the last level, we should be able to finish Nightmare Mode. Oh! Thank you. But now that I'm actually starting this level, I'm remembering what it is and how problematic it can be. Case in point, this room right here. That was bullshit. Thought I was dead there. Okay. And again, I thought I was dead there. Yikes. Okay. I really need to focus and pay more attention here. I keep screwing up, and sooner or later my screw-ups are going to cost me. Just go out on a limb here and assume that that armor reduces the amount of damage I take. Man, I'm actually going to be using a lot more of my weapon points now that I know that the shield actually carries over. I'll try not to use it too much though. Although, given, it produces a scroll anyway, okay. Given how easy it is to come by, weapon points, there's really no reason for me to not use the shield all the time. So he can't take damage unless he's not on fire. I don't have an Alfred's Ice spell, so I can't freeze him. Assuming that would freeze him, then I can't go that way now, can I? Unless I'm willing to take damage to try to go through him. Oh, that actually worked. But now, Jebel's almost dead, and that's not good. No! Okay. I don't know why I stuck to using Alfred for that section, but yes, G-Boy really needed that. No. Of course it has to miss. Come on. Yes. At least I beat it without taking a hit. That's the most important. Well, it wasn't worth it anyway, so I basically just wasted weapon points. Great. I wasn't prepared to... No, it doesn't look like... Wait, what? I wonder how I'm supposed to get through that door. I'm thinking Miriam will need it more than Jibo, even though he's almost dead. I wasn't sure about that jump, actually. That was actually... Oh, and I missed the health. Damn it. I think this is the end of the level, though. Or not. I remember the end of the level being different, unless I'm mistaken. Oh no, I'm pretty sure this is the end of the level, right? No. Okay. Well, at least that's cleared up. I didn't see that there. Excuse me. I don't like these pixies flying around. Pixies, fairies, whatever they may be. I don't like the looks of this either. Okay. managed to dodge a strike. Really needed that. There doesn't seem to be anything else here. Alright. Okay, I think this is the end of the level. But for sure this time. Maybe. I'm actually not sure. Okay, yeah, now I'm sure. This is in fact the end of the level. But I gotta get through some more of these guys first. Oh, Miriam might actually be better for this fight. Yeah, because it's this guy. No! Okay. Son of a... God, this guy's fast. He barely gives you any time to hit him, though. Nice. I wasn't fast enough to dodge it the first time either. But yeah, like I said, that boss is way easier than the two that come before it, so... I figured as long as I made it to the boss without dying, I could clear that level without losing a life. And now we approach the end. Fallen Moon's Requiem. Oh! Oh, the entire stage is different. Oh, each character has their own section. Oh shit. There's new enemies? Oh my god. Yo. Oh god, this puts so much more pressure on. Oh god. I'm glad I decided not to fight those guys. Please let there be hidden health somewhere. Oh, what the hell? Probably. Oh, okay. Because I was about to say, probably the way this works is, if you die on a certain character section, you lose a life, and that makes things so much harder. And of course, they have to put one in a place where you can't reach it. Spells in midair. Fuck! I knew it. I don't even know what happened there. I should have made that. I'm gonna lose all my lives just on Alfred's part. Seems like I gotta wait till the very last moment to jump. We can kill the fireballs, nice. Really gotta be extra careful here. Wow, even that I just barely made. Surprisingly easy for Alfred. Oh, this kind of reminds me of the beginning of the final stage in Yoshi's Island, where you have to transfer into a helicopter and fly over a bottomless pit. Background's kind of similar too. Anti-air defenses. Shit. Fuck. I don't want to die again. Please don't let me die again. Please. Oh, I'm gonna die here, aren't I? I'm dead for sure. I'm absolutely dead. Good, I can switch again, but I don't have the optimal weapon for Miriam, and Jebel, whatever his name is, almost dead, and oh boy, real Castlevania vibes here right now. No health, though. That's unfortunate. I could really use it for Jeeble, Jubble, Gebble, whatever his name is. However you pronounce it. And there he is. Oh! Oh, shit. Oh! Oh, what? Oh, I see. Wow. No. I was not expecting this. Oh boy. I could very easily lose all of my lives just from trying to beat this boss. Or, yeah, okay. Alright. That's kind of a relief, but I still have to figure out a way to... Yeah, this is definitely going to be trial and error. What? Oh my god. Wow, you gotta react extremely fast to be able to beat this guy. Your reaction's gotta be on point. I jumped too soon. Oh! Thought he was... Okay, so... Oh no. God, there's no way to know what he's gonna do from that attack. Yeah. My choice of sub-weapon doesn't seem to matter in this fight at all. Seems like the only way I'm gonna be able to damage him is with my regular weapon. Wow. Oh no. Ugh. Wow, I still was not able to get there before he could hit me. Yeah, you basically have to start jumping, but like before he hits the ground. But then he could do that instead, and as far as I can tell, there's no way to tell the difference between. And he does that so fast and you can't see it coming, so. I know how to react to each of the attacks, it's just. They're not. You can't know the difference between which is which unless there's some subtle differences that I'm not seeing because they're just happening so fast. As soon as he gets on the wall, he appears to decide what attack he's gonna do next, and if he decides to throw the sword, that's what makes this fight so hard. You have to be in the center in order to react fast enough to his fireball attack, but if he decides to throw his sword in the center anyway, then there's no way to react in time to avoid getting hit by it. Decision when trying to avoid the fireball attack, and he instead decides to use the crescent moon attack. Sword attack is just so big. God. And of course, I don't make it in time even when I react fast enough. How are you even supposed to dodge that? Oh my god, I'm dead already. There's no way to dodge that. I was dead anyway. But I think I'm starting to get the hang of this though. I'm really grateful for these infinite lives though. Certainly I would have lost all my lives by now had they not been there. Ridiculously fast in order to beat this. There's no way that... Oh, shit. I mean, it's a phase two. The new era of darkness came to an end. However, their failure to save their ally's life weighed heavily upon their hearts. In the end, they only had enough power to save his soul. May this land and his soul know true peace. Excuse me. Aww. Bittersweet ending. Okay, so that didn't take as long as I thought it would. Though certainly that was much harder than everything else that came before it. Though I imagine it's still probably easier than the NES Castlevanias. Yeah, most definitely. I mean, I'm saying this taking into consideration how long it took for me to beat it. I'm sure if I were to try to beat any of the NES Castlevania games, it would take me way longer to do so. I'm not trying to say that's a bad thing against this game, by any means. I think the fact that they give you infinite lives before the final boss is definitely better than, you know, not. Because, yeah, it gives you infinite lives, but you don't have to take them. You know what I mean? It's up to you whether or not if you want an infinite amount of tries at the final boss. So, you know, if you want to put that torture upon yourself to only have as many tries as you have when you get to the final boss, then that's up to you. But, you know, for some people, they would prefer to be able to have an unlimited amount of tries at the final boss without needing to replay the entire level, if they have that option. Thank you for playing. Zangetsu's soul remained behind where it was driven into the afterlife. This is like the intro to Mega Man 2, but in reverse. Oh, the end? Oh, wow. Okay, I wasn't expecting that. And certainly, I'm interested in seeing, you know, where Curse of the Moon 2 would go given that ending. So yeah, now that Nightmare Mode's beat, clear the game under certain conditions to unlock this mode. Now that Nightmare Mode's beat, I guess the only thing left I have to do is, get the rest of the achievements. For this game, however, they don't tell you what you need to do to get the achievements until after you unlock them, so I'm actually gonna go and look them up real quick. I noticed that I didn't get everything, every upgrade that is, my first time playing through this game, so I assume one of them is beat the game with all upgrades. I'll find out now when I look it up. Okay, so seeing the descriptions for the achievements, I'm a little confused about two of them. One says, finish the game without sacrificing or recruiting any adventurers, And another says, go it alone and see the normal ending. So what's the difference between beating the game without recruiting anybody or sacrificing anybody? And I guess go it alone means... But wait, doesn't that... If I'm not sacrificing or recruiting anybody, isn't that the exact same thing as going it alone? I don't know. All I know is that, I'll go for that achievement first, seeing as how that seems like it would be the hardest one to get. Alright, we can skip that since I'm already familiar with it. This is good though, because it'll force me to get good at the game without having to rely on the other characters. This is pretty much just going to be the exact opposite of nightmare mode, essentially. This is going to be painful for sure, especially since, if I remember correctly, I need specific characters to get certain upgrades. Yeah, like, just from the second level, you need Miriam to get that upgrade to your magic. Though, so I shouldn't be using my whip too much. But I made it to the train with full health, so... Hold on a second. Got an itch in my eye. Oh, I didn't see that enemy there. What the hell? Come on. I guess it's because I... Whoa! Well, so much for full health. Damn it. Oh boy, this is going to be hell. Wasting all my weapon energy. What am I doing? Oh boy, and I have to get past this guy. Full health, but close to it. And they seem to give you enough weapon energy to max yourself out by the end anyway. Ah. Luckily, the first boss is easy enough that, well, I mean, first boss, so of course you wouldn't have anything going up against it, so, yeah. I suppose that's nothing to comment on. I vowed to trust no one and fought my way here by myself. I seem to have reached my limits. No one is without strengths and weaknesses. Continuing alone would be a foolish journey. If only I had an ally I could trust. If I were to meet someone like that whom I could form an alliance with, I'd exclaim, "Let us fight together." No matter what powerful skill I may learn, it would never be a trusty companion. I've heard that there is a man cursed to drift against the flow of time. If such a curse were to exist, even I could defy the past and start anew. Come on, press the button. Ah, this is trouble. Or not. To avoid a problem there. Yeah, I'm not gonna be able to go that way. No! Fuck! At least the checkpoint's right here. But still, God, that's annoying. And I imagine that's going to happen to me a lot, trying to beat the game this way. Oh my god, I nearly avoided falling off again right there. That was so lucky. Oh my god. Oh my god. Thank you. Oh, come on. Oh, I'm dead. I'm... I'm gonna lose all my lives as early as the second. Oh, Jesus Christ. I feel like restarting already. Section alone, it's gonna cause me to lose all my lives. At the achievement descriptions, it didn't say anything about what difficulty I needed to play on, so if I can't get past that one section, I'll switch over to casual for this level and then go back to veteran after. To him. What? Oh, that's not good. Wait. What is this? What does this do? It's not a shield of any kind. You would think being on fire would make it so that enemies can't touch you. And, yeah, I'm gonna die before I even get to the room that I'm stuck on. Well, I made it, but it doesn't matter since I'm gonna die anyway, especially since I don't have the whip. And even if I had enough health to survive, I would have fallen down the pit. Well, I have the whip back now, so maybe I'll be able to get past that room. That's a big maybe. I think I actually got past that room without getting hit. Oh! And then I had to go and jinx myself. Let me make it past this room at least, please. So many things in this game are a lot harder to deal with when don't have your partners. Like these guys, for example. Come on, I jumped. You. Okay, good. Same sub weapon. Jesus. I hit this guy twice before, so I don't understand why he didn't die. What does the scroll do again? Alright, that. And there goes the first upgrade that I can't get. No, it's better for me to have this for this boss. No, okay, good. This boss might actually, this boss is definitely going to cost me all my lives. I might have to switch over to casual just from this boss alone. Come on! I ducked. I mean, I also tried to use my sub weapon, but I ducked. I have to go through these guys again. I'm gonna die before I even get to the boss now. Come on. Yeah, I'm gonna need to switch over to casual, just for this level. This boss is way too hard for me to beat. This isn't Getsu only. Infinite lives, nice. I'm not sure if I want that sub-weapon this early. Oh wow. Regular enemies give full health drops too. Wow. Wow. Wow, they really overdid it with making casual easy. And you don't get knocked back when you take damage. Wow. Wow. This game just went from being ridiculously hard to way too easy. I still don't know what this thing does. Maybe it's a power-up of some kind. Certainly the fact that I'm not going to get knocked back here is already going to be a godsend in the next few rooms. Yeah, like... yeah, like see, I didn't even worry about dodging him there because he wasn't going to knock me back. Still, obviously not good to get hit though. Oh, I'll grab that. Seem to be as many enemies either. Yeah. Normally I would be getting hit on both sides sooner there. Oh, and I just noticed that my weapon count is maxed out even though I don't have any upgrades. I didn't. Well, actually, for this section, I do want that. Wow. I must have hit him on just the barely the last frame of the whip attack. But yeah, these guys are the reason why I said I would like to have the scroll weapon early. I mean, with how easy this has been so far, I imagine the boss is also going to take less health to kill. Oh, I actually do need to... Fuck you. Well, I only lost one bar of health, so it's not a big deal. I wouldn't be surprised if I kill the boss super fast from playing on casual. Okay. Oh, right. Still die anyway. Oh no. I'm gonna get... Okay. Wow. Oh my god. How pathetic is this going to be if... Okay, good. So I was about to say, if I can't beat the boss on casual... And of course, I still can't dodge the final hit even when playing on casual. Wow. I will say, though, I am thankful for the fact that, I can switch between difficulties on the fly instead of being forced to be committed to just one for the whole playthrough. Alright, as promised, I'm going to go back to Veteran now. Well, I wouldn't be surprised if I have to switch difficulties again multiple times throughout this playthrough. No! I timed that poorly. Gotta remember that they fall as they're just above you and not sooner. Ah. Alright, well, that's an improvement at least. Come on. Come on, let me outrun him. Okay, I'm surprised that worked. Oh, nice, I got a health drop. Not that it mattered. Fell there. It's not even gonna make it to the boss, and I'm already switching back to casual. Jesus. Those things worked. Okay, this is a power up since I'm killing these things in one hit now instead of casual it is. Can't even make it to the boss. How pathetic. At this rate, I might as well just play through the rest of the whole game in casual without switching back. No, of course the power up has to wear out or whatever, run out when I decide to attack. Good thing there's infinite lives in casual. I guess we're not going that way. Good. Rest easy. Or can I? Jesus. I hate these bats. How foolish of me to ask if I can rest easy when playing in casual. So much for me getting good, right? And certainly the rewards aren't as good since, you know, if there's infinite lives, you can't exactly make one-ups reward for exploration or whatever. Wait, what boss was this? I'm trying to think if the weapon I have now is good for what I'm going to be going up against or not. But certainly that's... Alright, it's... Okay, now I remember. Ideally, I'll want the whip for this boss. I got it. Oh, come on. Please give me health. Thank you. So I'm at the boss now, right? Nope. And there's the health upgrade I can't get, thanks to not having Miriam. Yeah, there's no way I can get this without her. This is one of the easier bosses in the game. Oh, right, I forgot. Beat him already. Although it doesn't look like I beat him any faster than I would if I had been playing on a veteran. Excuse me. I hate doing this every single time, but it's kind of a necessity. I'm probably not gonna... Like, if I have to switch again, then I'm probably just going to stick to, casual mode for the rest of the playthrough. Take this path. And again, I can't go that way, so I have no choice but to take the long way around. Oh my god, these guys. Beginning. I did it again. Wait. I'll try to make the best of what I have. It's not looking good for me, though. At least I got the whip back. I'm gonna try to approach this a little differently. Since I don't have the scroll. At least I made it past this part. I just remember what the boss at this level is. Oh man, I don't know how I'm gonna be able to beat it. Always then get to. One thing's for certain, I'm gonna need to keep the whip for the boss. Okay, I'm just gonna stick to casual for the rest of this playthrough. Okay. Granted, I wasn't really in any real danger since I don't get knocked back in casual, but... I would have died there if this was still veteran. And we're back at this room again. And hey, we made progress now. These things again, and of course you cannot run them. Let me just let that be a checkpoint. I don't want to have to do that again. Jabal. Oh, this is different. Yeah, I knew those blocks were gonna crumble as soon as I saw them. Wow. Wow. Fuck you. At least I don't have to deal with the frogs again. Now, as much as I'm struggling with the Zengetsu Oni, at least I am seeing the game in a different way. So I can't complain too much. I might not be in danger of getting knocked back, but those things are still... Please give me health. No, what? caught me off guard when he jumped at me. Oh, nice. I should be saving my weapon energy for the boss. I'm definitely gonna need it for this one. Again, I made the mistake of forgetting that I'm in casual mode, so maybe the weapon's energy isn't something that I need to conserve as much as I think it is. Oh, that's bad. But I think I'm at the boss now, so I should be good. As long as I don't get hit on the way up. Nice. Oh boy. Okay. So boss patterns appear to be different too, on casual. To be easier. Since I didn't get the fireball attack. Barely avoided that. And that time I didn't. Oh well, it's casual, so didn't matter. Off to a great start. I'm thinking about which sub-weapon I should have for this boss. I'm not sure if I want the whip or the black hole thing. The scroll. I think I haven't seen this path before. Ah. I needed that. Wow, these guys are everywhere. I prefer to have the whip for this mini boss. Yeah. I don't know how I can, Well, okay, I suppose that works, but, Wow, I just barely avoided getting hit there. As I progress through this level, I'm starting to feel more and more like I should have the whip instead of the scroll. Well, I got what I wanted, but I wanted it sooner than when I got it. Actually, Wow, I just barely managed to grab that. I'm pretty sure that's a one-up in veteran mode. Come on. Yeah, I would have died there if this was veteran. And I got the scroll back. Good. So that's what I want for the boss. We're not there yet, though. Of course, I had to completely screw that up. Did I not jump at the right time? I should probably use my whip on that guy before picking up the scroll. Use Miriam, she would have enough height in her jump that this wouldn't be a problem. Now I'm actually not sure how I'm gonna get past this part. Jump like at the very, very, very edge of the platform there. Of course I can't make it if that guy's... Alright, I'm gonna need to use the whip on both him and the other guy before I grab the scroll. Although, now that I think about it, I probably won't be able to go back to get the scroll due to wind fighting my jumps. Yeah, there's no way I can make that. Oh, okay, never mind. It works out anyway because the game gives you a scroll anyway. I don't know how I made that. That looked like it was gonna miss. Green lantern gives, since I don't have Alpha. Well, knowing this game, it probably, maybe the whip was better after all. Storm Eagle. Use your other attack. Give me a chance to hit you. Gonna die now since I've lost too much health already. Oh, wait. Oh, no. And then she's gonna... Yeah. At least I remembered how to dodge the second part. I am tempted to do level 7 on Veteran, though. Since I can easily take on that boss. But we'll see, you know, how the level treats me once we get there. Excuse me. Yeah. That sand's gonna kill me if I touch it, and I can't slide, which means I can't pick that up. Ah, well, now I know what happens if you, So that always drops a lightning scroll. But I don't have Alfred, so I don't pick it up. Never mind. I should see if this, I was hoping for a health drop. Wait. Yeah. For this boss, I'll want the health, the whip. But I probably should have waited to get it. Okay. Don't even need to bother with him. No! Yeah, much better to also not deal with these guys as well. Yeah, some enemies... It's better just to not fight them at all. I've learned that. Come on, I hit him. I thought I saw a different one shake. These girls, yeah, not gonna fight them either. If I had not back on, I wouldn't have died there. In an odd situation where knockback would have actually saved me instead of the other way around. I keep forgetting though that this is casual, so I'm acting way more relieved than I should over. What the fuck? Come on, I pressed up. Oh, I didn't mean to pick that up. Room again. Not a good idea to try to. Oh, this is a disaster. Is now I'll have the whip back, but there's no way I'm getting through this without taking damage. Okay, I'll take that. So really bad. Oh, I'm so dead. I've never been able to dodge her final attack before. So does the final attack not kill you or something? I should have died there. Alright. I'll try to be at least this level on veteran. And if I can't, then I'll go back to casual. And it's all because of the boss. I'm pretty sure I can beat him on veteran, but getting to him may prove to be a problem. Just looking at this first room, Yeah. Oh, it doesn't go far enough. Damn it. Probably a really bad idea to not fight them. Come on. I jumped onto the stairs. Wow. You take so much damage. I'm a veteran. This is already looking to be back to casual again. I'm not even sure why I even bothered attempting to do this. Such a tease. It's right there, yet you can't grab it. Just gotta keep in mind, you don't need to fight everything. As long as I remember that, I should be good. Worth it. Oh, hello. A full health pickup would have been nice, or another one up. If I'm back at the start of the level, yep, back to casual. Even on casual, those frogs do a lot of... damage that doesn't matter if you fall to your death anyway. Almost made it through there without getting hurt. Thank you. God, I'm gonna need to play through this first screen so many times. Why? Died there again. I'm never getting past this first screen. Oh, what? Oh, so there's also more checkpoints in casual. Thank God. I don't care if this is the longer route, but I'm not going through that again. What? Oh my. Now the game's giving me no choice. More than anything else in this game. This fucking room again! Okay, I got lucky that time. Can I just cheat at this point, please? I think I earned it, right? Why should I have to play through this room again? Get on the stairs. I was about to get hit. No, no. Come on. Please be a checkpoint, and I don't want to have to go through that room again. Oh, I'm out of weapon points. Oh my God. Okay, that wasn't as big of a deal as I thought it was gonna be. Whoa, that was super close. And good thing that frog killed itself. Thank you. I shouldn't have tried to jump to get on the stairs there. That was really stupid and risky for me to do. Alright, I have to go that way. For some reason I thought I was going up. I think this may be my first time playing through this area, because since I have the other characters, I would normally take a different route. Yeah, this is the other side of this room. I recognize this place. It might be better for me to have the scroll for this boss fight. Yeah, there was no way I was gonna be able to get through this Zengetsu only in there. Still got hit. Oh, come on. But yeah, you can see why I wanted to try to beat that boss on Veteran. I certainly think it would have been possible for me to do so. Cleave the Moon. Wasn't this originally called Curse of the Moon? That's right, I forgot about that. Alright, remember, I gotta treat this like an auto scroll. Down the stairs! I don't know how I'm supposed to avoid that. I'm gonna die. That was close. Wait, am I at the boss already? I was just barely fast enough. Of course. Of course, it has to be a barrage of the worst enemy in the game for the final stretch. I can't believe I just survived that. Oh my god. I don't want to fight the boss with less than full health.
So
I'm not gonna survive this though, because I don't have enough health. And I have no weapon energy, so. I think I might be at a dead end here. This might be as far as I go with Zangetsu only. Make it all the way to the end only to fail. How the bat pattern works though. I take far too much damage in this first phase for this to be feasible. I should have just let her kill me. Now I'm gonna waste time sitting through this cutscene, only to... Come on. or any of the platforms to be able to make it. Why? It's not what I wanted to do. I'm just gonna look this up because I can't figure out how her hand patterns work. Try to have that remembered. Also, it might be better for me to take the scroll. No, come on. Well, this attempt is dead anyway. Oh my god. Even after looking up how the hands work, I still can't avoid taking too much damage. Man, I just realized how late it is. Jumped. Fuck. Okay, this time I actually didn't lose that much health. I might actually have a chance now. Come on. How am I supposed to avoid getting hit? Oh my fucking god. This is bad. I think I only got hit 3 times there. Finally, I get the yellow ones. Okay, I gotta memorize that attack. And this could be... I'm very close to dying here. Don't jump there. Don't jump there. Don't jump there. This is a dead fight. I'm pretty much dead here. Yeah, definitely. There's no way to avoid getting hit by them. Gonna make it. I already have less health than what I should have for next phase of the fight. Ah. Nice. Only got hit one time this time. Man, I didn't realize how late it was. Probably gonna end the stream after I finish this boss fight. If I can finish it by tonight. I don't wanna go on for too long. I'm not even sure how long I've been streaming for. When did I start, like 4 o'clock or something? Maybe 4:30? I'll try to finish this boss fight. Come on, why did I get hit there? Made it this far already. I've still got plenty of. Wow. Yellow moons again. Very nice. Hordes of demons have been felled, and a sacrifice had been made, and finally the mighty evil was destroyed. However, in the midst of battle, Zangetsu had realized something. This world and everything in it was crafted by the demon Grammary, and shown to him alone by the curse of the moon. As the castle crumbled, as the world crumbled, Zangetsu thought. Through his own hesitation, he could neither kill nor ally with the abominable alchemist and shard binders. And as he looked upon them, after they risked their lives to save him, they revealed to him his own weakness. At that moment, something within him began to change. Thus, with a premonition of the coming battle, he dove once again into the spreading darkness. Finn. So, that ending's kind of bittersweet, too. I was going to say it seems being the game's end gets to only, without recruiting anyone, does seem to be the best ending, but now, after reading all that, it seems like this ending's bittersweet as well. Thank you for playing. Alright, I think I'm gonna cut it here, actually. I wanna get something to eat. I hope you guys enjoyed the stream. I keep saying, you know, I'm gonna stream every day, I'm gonna stream every day. I actually am gonna try to stream every day from now on. My dad's gonna be going away for 3 days or 4 days, you know, on Sunday or Monday, so I'll be home all by myself, you know, nobody to interrupt or disrupt the stream whatsoever, so that'll be nice. And I could stream for as long as I want as well, so. But at the same time, that would also be a good opportunity to work on some YouTube videos I've been meaning to make. I don't know. We'll see what I do. I'll probably do a combination of both. Have longer streams and work on YouTube videos. But yeah, that's going to be it for me for tonight. Hope you all enjoyed. Don't forget to follow, subscribe to the YouTube channel. And yeah. Have a good night, everybody.